Hello everybody, my name is Mark Wignall. I'm head teacher at Downlands Community School. Welcome to our virtual open evening. I'm really sorry we can't be together for open evening this year, but we do hope to provide opportunities for you and your families to come in and look at the school. We come up here to the Jack and Jill windmills near Clayton because the windmills are our school logo, but it also gives an opportunity to show off what a wonderful location Downlands is situated.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the hall. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame.
Yeah.
And the world.
We're really proud of the educational outcomes young people achieve whilst they're at Downlands. And I do mean GCSE results. Students achieve extremely well at Downlands. Proud of the curriculum, the rich curriculum that we provide for the students, all the opportunities that we provide, whether it's PE or dance or drama or art or forest schools or any of the other brilliant opportunities that we provide, including trips and activities out of school.
Welcome to Downlands Year 7 News. Hi, my name's Edie, and last year I was Year 6. Soon you'll be starting Downlands too, and there are a few things you'll need to know.
If you're nervous for secondary school, just think about all the good things that could happen.
They're brilliant teachers, and you'll have a lovely pastoral support officer who you can always count on if you need help with anything.
I used to be scared on my first day, but then I met a lot of people, and they were so nice, and the teachers were amazing.
Don't be worried about getting lost. There'll be prefects from Year 11 to make sure you get to class on time for the first few weeks. It's a lot of fun starting Downlands. Just remember to work hard and enjoy yourself.
Downlands Community School is an 8-form entry, mixed ability, comprehensive school maintained by West Sussex LEA. We have 240 students in each year group, and each year group has 8 tutor groups of 30 students. Our catchment area is, of course, mainly in West Sussex. The outlying villages, Hurstpier Point, Keema, Hassocks, Alborne, Sayers Common, but it also includes a very small part of East Sussex, that's Ditchling and a part of Westminster. We do encourage families who want to come to Downlands to put us down first on their application form. There's the only realistic way you will get into Downlands, and each year students from outside our catchment area do actually get in. But if you do live outside our catchment area and you want to talk to someone, please do make contact with the school.
Throughout my journey at Downlands, I've definitely had some of the most memorable experiences, learning opportunities, and amazing development of my personality.
Being at Downlands has helped me grow into the person I am today. I've never found the academic side of things easy, but with help from my teachers, I've managed to continue to learn and thrive throughout my secondary school years.
I couldn't thank every staff member enough for the hard work, extra hours, and unconditional respect for everyone, shaping Downlands into a true community. The pastoral team is flawless, offering help and support for any pupil that needs it.
I think that my favourite part of being a part of this community would definitely be taking part in the annual drama production. It's just such a brilliant way of bringing students and staff closer together.
My favourite part about Downlands has got to be the trips, in particular Iceland and the ski trip. I'll remember those for the rest of my life.
I've made so many wonderful memories here, and I hope that you'll get the chance to do the same. I'd like to say that without a doubt, my experience at Downlands has been outstanding.
Throughout my career at Downlands, I've been constantly inspired by teachers to push for success, no matter what. My development as a leader began from just year 7, where I would watch the sports leaders running our PE sessions, or seeing the prefects in the hallways. Downlands, without a doubt, pushes you to excel, both academically and with real-life skills.
Downlands is a community school, and we were very, very pleased that Ofsted recognised that we're not just a community school by name, we're a real community school. We engage really well with the community. This is our beautiful new amphitheatre. The amphitheatre was created with funds raised from our community, so no another school budget was used, all money came from the community. We have a wonderful PTA called the Downlands Association, made up of some brilliant and intrepid parents, and every year they raise a really significant amount of money that we use for projects around the school. So when you come next year, we'll be really encouraging you guys to join the Downlands Association, get involved. It's a really good way of getting involved in your child's school. I'm talking to you now from our sports centre, and we're really lucky with the brilliant sports facilities that we have on site, with our sports hall, our floodlit 3G pitch, which has just been resurfaced, our extensive playing fields, our dance studio, and of course our fully functioning gym. This centre is also open to our community. It's a thriving sports centre. It has literally tens of thousands of visits from local people every year. And we always try to work very, very closely with our community, whether it's local people, whether it's parents, whether it's businesses, whether it's local clubs. We work hand in hand with as many local people as we can, because we know that when we work with our community, we are stronger together and our young people do better as a result. Another area we're very proud of at Downlands is the care and support that we offer to all members of our community. Each year group of 240 students is led by an achievement leader, but also has a pastoral support officer attached to it. And that pastoral support officer provides 37 hours of dedicated support for the students in that year group. Each tutor group has a tutor, and we also have colleagues who support behaviour. We have a careers officer, we have learning mentors, we have a school counsellor, many, many other colleagues who are there to support the students in their journey through Downlands. They were also extremely keen that students are kind to each other and all members of the community. So we talk every day about how important kindness to everyone else is, and we talk about the importance of those small acts of kindness on a daily basis, whether it's smiling at someone, picking something up for someone, holding a door. They all add to that sense of community that makes Downland such a pleasant place to live and work. Well, we're coming towards the end of our virtual open evening. I hope you enjoyed it to some extent. I hope you found it useful and informative. We're really sad we didn't get to meet you all in person, and we are really looking forward to today when we can do that. So we will create opportunities to meet up. We'll create opportunities for you to come in and see what's happening at Downlands at first hand when we can. And we're all hoping that that will be sooner rather than later, but we're living in a very fluid times, and we'll just have to wait and see. So thank you for joining us. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to be answering a number of questions that were sent in by parents. We asked parents to send questions in. So if you don't want to listen to the answers to those questions, please do turn this off now. If you do, then we'll continue. If you have any questions about SE and D support, please contact Vicky Cornish. She is our Senko. You can contact her on bcornish@downlands.org, and she is ready and waiting to answer your questions. Okay, first question, do you set? Well, I, in fact, give the responsibility in terms of deciding the organisation of departments to the faculty heads. So we do have some departments that are mixed ability all the way through, and we have some departments that set right from the start. For example, mathematics. After the first few weeks, they are put into ability groups. In science, from year nine, they are set by ability. Largely, groups are mixed ability, and in practice, what I say to our middle leaders is, you can decide how you organise your faculties as long as you achieve outstanding results. And they do, which is good to see. And that's why we've got a mixed economy. In fact, my view on it is, what's really important is the quality of your teacher and the quality of the teaching and learning in the classroom. And again, that's where we're extremely fortunate. We've got such a great body of teaching staff. We work really hard to hone our craft and to improve outcomes all of the time. Next question, do you have an early entry GCSE policy? No, we don't. In line with most schools, all exams are done in the summer of year 11. We do have a number of vocational courses where exams are done throughout year 10 and 11, and of course you can study those and you choose them as an option. Do you provide any wraparound care and after-school clubs? Well, we open our doors from 8:30 in the morning when the canteen is open so students can get a breakfast. And after school, our library is open till 4 p.m. so students can catch up with some work or do homework. And we have a vast plethora of after-school activities. So we're very, very proud of the activities and the number of clubs and trips and teams and sports that we offer. But every year we're trying to increase the number. So we're always trying to increase the number of opportunities for our youngsters. And we now track our youngsters, and so we find out what they're involved in. And if they're not involved in anything, then we are actively encouraging them to do so. Because when you engage in your school, when you engage in your education, then you do get better educational outcomes. So we're really keen on that, not just because it's brilliant, but it's actually really good for young people too. How do we support high achievers? Well, our entire teaching and learning approach is based on challenging everyone in the classroom. So we are challenging everyone of all abilities, even those students with grade 9 expectations. And what we tend to do is then we support everyone else by scaffolding down and making sure that everybody in that classroom is making progress. We may have to support lower achievers, but that's built into our teaching and learning policy. And every year we get brilliant outcomes for our high achievers. Each year we've got students getting 10 grade 9s, which is absolutely unbelievable. So we're big believers in challenging everybody. Do the year 7s have a buddy system or a mentor? So in a normal year, our year sevens will come in and they have a dedicated space to themselves at breaks and lunches. Up to now, that's been the year seven courtyard. This year, as it goes, because of the bubble system we're using, it's a lovely amphitheatre, so they've been very lucky. So no one else can go in there, they stay in there until they feel confident enough to leave that dedicated space. And not just a fantastic pastoral team with an achievement leader, as I mentioned, and a PSO dedicated to support them and all the other staff I mentioned doing support, but each tutor group has three year 11 prefects. And they really look forward to that role. And they really support the year sevens so well. They understand the systems and they will literally at the start, they will take them from to their tutor time, to the lesson one, to the next lesson, to break, pick them up after break and take them all the way around the school for a couple of weeks. And that's how long it takes really to get used to getting around the school on your own. They do a great job. When the students come in, we let them go to lunch early, just so they got a little bit more time. But again, after a few days now, they're used to that and getting used to the routines. So lots and lots of very, very supportive transition. How many new teachers started in the past 2 years? So I think that's about the stability of our staff. And in practice, we don't have a lot of staff turnover. It's a wonderful place to work. You only have to look out the back and see the beautiful location, which helps. But we work as a big team. We like to work as a big team, and I think that's one of the things that makes us extremely successful. And we do have people leaving, but they tend to be through retirement or through promotion, and that's healthy turnover as far as I'm concerned. What languages are offered? So we offer French, German and Spanish. And what we do is in year seven, students come in and they will be in a particular tutor group, and that particular tutor group will study a language, a given language. The students then carry on that language all the way through to GCSE. So they become masters of that language. They become very good at it, hence we're achieving very good outcomes at GCSE. And we're being very, very successful with the languages. Who gets to do separate sciences at GCSE? Well, we don't decide until year nine who's doing separate sciences. It's a smallish number. In practice, it's about 30 to 40 students. You don't need separate sciences to do A-level science. So you don't need to do separate sciences to go on to do whatever career you want to be involved in, whether it's being a doctor or a neurosurgeon or whatever. So in practice, separate sciences are for students of all abilities who just really, really like science. But we study the three separate sciences in the same time that we do the double science. So it is very challenging. And the students need to be very, very motivated with their science to do it. And again, we are looking at a particular, you know, we're looking at a particular kind of student because it's quite demanding. Where do students go when they leave? So there is no, we don't have a sixth form, as you know. And there are a number of sixth form colleges in practice because it's quite easy to get to Brighton. A lot of our students at the moment go to Vyndean or Baswick. Haywards Heath sixth form has just reopened, and that is in Haywards Heath. And again, that's very accessible, and it seems to they've got a very good offer too. But other students go off and do apprenticeships. They go to Brighton Met. We have students going to Lewis, Northbrook, and in practice, a wide range, but it is mainly Brighton, and it's the bright lights of Brighton. I think it's quite easy to get to. That's the end of the Q&A session. And so if you have any questions I haven't answered, then please do email the school and we will get an answer to you. So once again, thank you very much for joining us, and cheerio.